like to see out on court. Keeps the crowd entertained. Tough off the net cord.
So Matosevic gets a very important break here. And the more experienced campaigner is certainly on his way. 6-4, 2-1. We will take a break. PM will let you refuel at the back and have a couple of muesli bars. We'll be coming back with a whole lot more. Day two of the AO Wildcard Playoff.
Ready, play at Australian Open 2012. A ticket to the biggest sport and entertainment event of the Australian summer makes the perfect Christmas gift and outstanding value for the whole family. The best in the world are coming. So book at Ticketek now.
Tomica.com. You can log on there. We're going to see Bernie in action come the AO series and the lead up to the Australian Open, and then of course the two big weeks here at Melbourne Park as we welcome you back to Court 6. That is the scoreline. Marinko Matosevic, the number 2 seed, getting a break in the ninth game of the opening set. Close it out 6-4. He's got a break in the third game here, serving at 2-1. Yes, I welcome Andrew Leonard alongside me here. G'day, Andrew.
G'day, Brett. How you doing?
Very well. Sammy goes long with the backhand. You've been roaming around the courts.
Yeah, I was having a look at Mitchell and Barton earlier today, and it's interesting seeing how Barton lost his composure at one point as he lost that first set.
Yeah, I did watch a bit of that match. Certainly was pushed, Ben Mitchell. Come back. Sam going long with the backhand. Lot to like about Ben Mitchell, though, isn't it? I mean, he's a good young prospect. He's put on a bit of size. And he just keeps getting ball after ball back in court. Very consistent. Matosevic starting to run away here.
Just working Groth all over the court at the moment. And it was interesting speaking to Sammy Groth a couple of weeks ago, as we did. Didn't know if he was actually going to be playing here. So it's hard to prepare, I guess, if you're not sure if you're going to be playing.
Okay, Matosevic.
So Matosevic holds to love. He leads at 3-1 in this second set, having taken the first six games to 4. Yeah, it's certainly a long road back, isn't it? Played a bit of pennant up to Bendigo on the Pro Tour, now playing as part of the playoff, and I suppose you can't expect everything just to fall into place immediately. He would have been working very hard with his team to come back, having had a bit of time to sit out, look at his game, what does he need to improve.
15,
serving like that is generally pretty good when he gets it like that.
Such a powerful serve, isn't it, though, from Sam Groth.
Needs a high percentage of those to go in. Let's see if he can fight his way back. I'd like a nice, comfortable service game here. I'll update the outside courts in just a tick. Arina Rodionova, 6-love and 1-love in the second, leading Alison by at the moment, so making it light work there. Olivia Rogoska has taken the opening set against Daniela Jeffley, 6-3. And Nicholas Kyrgios, it's a good result. If he can close out that third set against the seeded Matt Reed. 4-1 he leads it at this stage. That is the live action around Melbourne Park. Groth comes up with a beauty down the middle. And he heads to the chair.
Tosovic leads 3-2.
A bit of confidence regained. And if he can get a break back, he can put himself right back in this match. What else have you noticed, Andrew? Just wandering around the court. So good little.
Well, just watching Sam Groth there with the errant ball toss on their first attempt at that serve and then managed to nail it the second time. Watching James Lemke this morning. I know he's a guy who's been struggling with his serve over the past year and had a lot of work been put into that. Just a number of times today during his match, just couldn't get that ball toss right, which probably ultimately affected his game. He did lead a break in that second set and came back and lost that second set when he probably should have taken it to three sets. So that was disappointing watching that game earlier today, from James Lemke's point of view at least.
Yep. If you're just joining us, we saw JP Smith on this court. There's a lot to like about him, isn't there? The left-hander from Queensland. He's been just hidden away over there in the United States.
Exactly right. What an exciting talent coming back, and hopefully we get to see more of him in the Australian summer and through the circuit tournaments. Only started playing challenger events really in that September period to try and get his ranking points up to try and make main draw of Grand Slams and main draw of some bigger tournaments around the world, playing that college scene for the last 4 years.
Greg Jones, who's so desperate to get into his first Australian Open main draw, got to the last round of qualifying last year. He's the top seed. He got through fairly comfortably earlier today.
I suppose Marenko Matosevic was in that position as Greg Jones was last year as well. So made the main draw, lost in the first round though of the Aussie Open. I remember watching him out here on, I think it was about probably this court actually, court six last year.
So he's got a strike here, Groth, in this game. He's able to get back Joe Daly. At Joe Daly. Thank you, Joe, for your tweet, Sam Groth. Has broken my headphones. Thanks, mate. Well, Joe, I'd be ducking down to any electrical store, JB. Get yourself a new pair of headphones.
Small opening for Groth now.
Turn from Groth, and he's now got a couple of break points at 15-40 on the Matosevic serve. Great shot from Sam Groth. And he's back in this second set. Three games all.
Much more composed game as well. On the return of serve, just often chipping the ball back and slicing the ball back into play just to make Matosevic make the play. And that's probably a conservative way to play and keeps you in the game.
So he's just been able to regain his composure and his belief. Matosevic, of course... When we look at Marenko's career, a late bloomer. Took a long time to play his first ATP event and has had a pretty sort of solid 12 to 18 months, but that ranking sort of went from 130 to about 200 in the blink of an eye, not able to defend some points.
Love 15.
good exchange between both players.
15-0.
Covering the court.
Always a challenge when you exert all that mental energy to get back into the contest to make sure you go and hold the next game, because you're back there now, so really important game this for Sam Groth as well.
And the big swinger out wide to good effect. Kosovic attacking the net, a big chance to hold here, so this has been a great comeback by Sam Groth. Knew as soon as he hit it, he was putting into a spot where he didn't want the ball to go. Conceded the point. Still with a game point here at 40-30. It comes up with a powerful first serve, a little clinch of the fist. And he's back with his nose in front, 4-3, second set. That man on screen, Marinko Matosevic, taking the first 6-4. So a great battle in this second round match. A spot in the quarterfinals up for grabs as we check around the courts. Arina Oradianova, 6-love, 2-1. She's doing it nicely over Alison Bai. But the big result just completed. Nicholas Kyrgios has defeated Matt Reed, the seeded Matt Reed, who was at number 7. Kyrgios, of course, from the ACT. He has got through. 6-2. And the match we're watching at the moment is out on court number 5. Rodionova and also Alison Bai. So Arena doing it very comfortably there. Olivia Rogoska is in charge of her match. 6-3. Games on serve in the second against Daniela Jeffley. 2-1. Storm Sanders, Victoria Rajic about to take to the court.
That Kyrgios upset's an interesting one. I thought before this game as well that this might be where the upset was going to come today from one of the seeded players being knocked out. But Matosevic on top, albeit just with a set lead at the moment.
Continues. So Matosevic looking to try and hold to love here and get it back to 4-all. Turn, but it went long, so Matosevic holds to love, 4 games apiece.
I think that's the difference, Groth there. We saw in the previous game when he managed to break back, he was poking the ball back into play, which allowed the ball that to have that chance to hit and load up on the second shot. That game there, he tried to hit through every single return, and when he tried to hit through, the ball was either hitting it long or into the net, so just didn't have the control to keep the ball in play.
Yeah, we've talked a fair bit about his consistency. That's the key. He's got plenty of power. Right, first serve.
15. No, but the call's come directly after that, so you've already missed the shot.
Oh, what a rookie again.
You know, every time it's a repo, right, you can get a rattle on it.
Not if the call comes after your shot.
Okay, man, whatever.
Ball, and I've hit it. So the chair umpire overruling.
40-15.
And Groth with a big slaughter out wide. He's able to keep his nose in front. 5-4 in this second set. Same pattern as the first. Well, Nicholas Kyrgios, what a performance by him earlier today. He's ousted Matt Reed. He's fresh off court and he's standing by to have a chat to our man Peter Mercado.
Great performance by you today. 3-set winner. The first set was very tight and then Matt just came back in that second set. How were you able to regroup in the third?
I knew Matt was going to come out. I mean, I won the first. I was playing probably the best tennis of all year I've played. And I knew Matt wasn't just going to throw it away. So he came back strong. I mean, he broke me at 3-all. And he was starting to play really good tennis. And in the third, I started to calm down a bit, you know, get my form back. And I got the W.
Well, you mentioned it was probably your best performance for the year. But how much confidence does this give you heading into the rest of the tournament?
It gives me a lot of confidence. I haven't seen much of Marinko or Sam play, but I know they both got pretty big games, so I'm going to have to be on my top game to have any chance.
We're just commenting on Sam's serve before. Those rockets you're going to be in front of, they're going to be tough to stop, aren't they?
Yeah, well, I guess that's what this game revolves around, so I've got to try and do my best, try and break his rhythm and see how it goes.
Obviously, getting a wild card, the aim of this week, but what about through January, through the Australian summer? What are your plans so far?
After this, I'll go back home. I'll go back for Christmas, spend a bit of time with the family, and then I think we're having a training camp at AIS, and then we'll head to Traralgon and then Junior Aussie Open.
And the preparation tonight, a little bit of celebrating tonight after that big win, or keep things low-key?
I think I've got to keep things low-key. I mean, I'm here with my dad, and we'll probably just... You know, this really good noodle place we found, so may just have dinner there and just chill out back at the apartments.
Well, enjoyed a magnificent performance today in 3 sets, and best of luck for the next round.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thanks, Pete. Pete Mercado there with Nick Kyrgios beating Matt Reed today. You wouldn't have thought he'd be hitting the town. Just a little bit of dinner to refuel and good night's sleep.
Very straight bat with his answers, wasn't it?
Yeah.
See, there it is again. Had control of the point, just make Matasevic play, and Groth couldn't help himself.
You summed it up beautifully. Yep. Rinko down the tee beautifully.
That could be a fitness thing too, not having the stamina to go to a big grinding point.
Mm. It's a point off Matosevic in this service game, which has been hard to come by. Marinko holds.
Five games. Oh.
Missed that, mate. Five all. Second set. Marinko took the first 6-4. Let's keep you updated with what is happening around the courts. Olivia Rogoska, 6-3, and she trails a 3-2. Daniela Jeffley in that match, which is currently out on court number 7. Irina Rodionova having a pretty comfortable day at the office. Alison Bayer, who's come in, of course, late into the draw. 6-love, 4-1, Irina Reeds at Leeds. She was out there practicing with Anastasia earlier today. Victoria Rajic and Storm Sanders warming up, just about ready to go on court 8.
Love 15.
Groth goes wide with the forehand.
Interesting seeing the difference in some of the score lines from the ladies' matches versus the men's. Wider margins generally across the board.
Good news for Casey DeLacca earlier today, getting back on track after that first round loss to Ashley Barty. She won very comfortably, 6-love, 6-1 against Emmeline Starr of New South Wales. Body there of Matosevic, hard to handle. Gets it back to 30 all. Day two of our AO wildcard playoff. Wherever you might be viewing, around Australia or around the world, whatever time zone, hope you're enjoying it. Beautiful day here in Melbourne, it's warm.
It's getting bigger every year, this event, isn't it?
Yeah, in the whole December showdown. Terrific month. Just long with the lob, so a chance here to hold the Groth.
Hold for Groth. 6-5 in the second set.
Grunt leads.
Matosevic will have to serve to stay in the set. Again, a more composed set, service game there from Groth as well. Just managing to keep the ball back in play, making Matosevic play every ball. Some scores from around the other courts. Arena Rodionova leading 6-love and 4-2 with a break against Alison Bai. Olivia Rogowska is on serve, but 3-4 down in the second set after taking the first set over Daniela and Jeffley. And match yet to get underway out on court 8 is Viktorija Radicic and Storm Sanders. A match just about to start as we're viewing pictures from court 5 at the moment.
So plenty of action right around the courts here at Melbourne Park, but we're in a tense battle here. Matosevic and Groth. Renko taking the opening set. Sam's got his nose in front in the second. Cracking return off the Groth racket. Well, it's good to watch when he winds it up. Set it all. 40, shot 15. Cross court from Matosevic. Good powerful exchange between both players, so looks like we're heading for a second set tiebreaker.
I heard you and Pete mention the crowds that have come in, and there is great crowds here for these showdown matches. And they're getting to see two great characters here fight it out at the moment. A slugging match at that point.
40-30.
Just cranked up a gear in his 12th game. Matosevic still with a game point to force the second set to a tiebreak. He does. Second set tiebreaker coming up.
Second set tiebreaker.
Sam Groth needing to square things up to take it to a third set, or can Marinko advance in straight? We're about to find out. Around the courts, Daniela Jeffley 4-3, leading Olivia Rogowska in the second set. Olivia took the first 6-3. Alison Bai fighting back in her match against Arina Rodionova, 6-love, 4-3. Arina leads in the second set. Rasic centres just out on court. Notice Sam's mum in the crowd today. I'm not sure where Phil, his dad, is. Mum's all in pink. Enjoying seeing his son back out on court.
One off.
Watching the Mitchell-Barton tiebreaker in the first set earlier today. Barton had a chance there to win that set, had the mini break in the tiebreaker, and got a line call that he didn't like, and just proceeded to lose the next 3 points and lose the tiebreaker, and I think that really troubled him for the rest of the match. So the psychology behind playing tiebreakers is massive.
Yeah, plenty of kick in the second serve, and then the big forehand from Sam Groth. Scampering Matosevic just to keep himself in the point and come up with a terrifically deep return. Groth was dictating terms at the back of the court. So the arm wrestle continues. Did look to be wide, but the chair umpire is the man who rules, so we're right on that line. It did look to me to be out, but they head to the chair and they'll swap ends at 3 points apiece in this tiebreaker. Renko frustrated with a couple of the calls this afternoon.
Just got to keep his head here, Marinko, because he's only a few points away from progressing. It's Groth that's got to make the running now, so.
So he just needs to walk away from over here, Marinko. He's still having a chat to the referee. Can't believe, or the chair umpire, I should say, can't believe the call.
Not helping his cause there.
Points away here, Sam Groth, from winning this second set. If he can continue in this fashion, he's got the advantage of still serving.
Five,
long from Groth, so he gives up that point. Natosevic back on serve now. Off long again.
Be disappointed with that. Big second serve. I know plenty of topspin. You can hear his disappointment.
So he gives up a little advantage that he had at 5-3. A match point here for Marinko Matosevic. It is back on serve though with Groth. What are we going to see here from Sam, Andrew?
Big down the tee, I think.
Okay. See if he's listening. Yeah. He went straight there. Followed your instructions beautifully. The players will change ends again. Marinko not happy with the call. He'll have some extended dialogue with the chair umpire again. So it's a tight second set tiebreaker.
Hello to our viewers in France.
Please translate. Who would be a chair umpire? Tough gig. Oh, he'd dig that from the shoelaces, Groth. And he doesn't like the call either. He thinks it was over the baseline.
I'd argue, Brett, I don't know a single sport where being the umpire is a great gig.
No, that's very true. So another match point coming up for Marinko Matosevic. Goes long. Marinko sends that up to Brisbane. A bit of emotion out on court six. And Marinko eventually prevails.
Not sure about the gestures towards the lines person.
6-4, 7-6. Marinko, not happy with the lines person. Tough job, but he's got the chocolates here and he's through to the quarterfinal stage of the Australian Open wildcard playoff. We'll no doubt get a word with him very shortly courtside. Marinko still pointing to the chair umpire. Sam Groth will leave the court. Let's get down there right now. Adrian Franklin is standing by and he is alongside the winner, Marinko Matosevic.
Marinko, well done. Did you feel like you had to work your way into the game a little bit out there?
Yeah, it's tough playing Sam's. He really does have one of the best serves in the world. A few years ago, he clicked the fastest serve of the Australian Open. It was hard to get my rhythm out. I played one bad game in the second, made a few unforced errors, and going back into it, and yeah, I don't know, just won it somehow in the end.
You had the bye in the first round, obviously. Is that advantageous for you, or would you prefer not to have something like that?
No, it's good to have a bye, but I haven't played a match since Shanghai Masters in early October, so I felt like I needed some matches, but you know, I'm happy to win that one.
You show some aggression out there, which is good to see. Is that something you enjoy doing? It gets you going a little bit?
Yeah, it definitely gets me going, but I mean, the officiating at the end was a very poor standard, I thought, for both guys. I don't know how that call was, but there was a few outballs, I thought, anyway, and I'd like to see it on replay or camera saying, but yeah, that really gets me frustrated and angry.
Sure. Sometimes you don't give us a hell of a lot in interviews sometimes, but I'd like to ask you personally, what do you do off the court? What do you like to get up to relax?
I love going to the movies. I play poker a lot. No, I work out a lot, actually. I have two trainers, Muddy Waters and the Tennis Australia trainer. Basically I just relax after a whole day of training.
Well, enjoy the rest of your afternoon.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Adrian. Down there, and it's a forthright Marinko Matosevic with his thoughts on the match, but he got through 6-4, 7-6. Who's reckon? Is that Sam's or Marinko's? It's in the bin. Might be Sam's. He wouldn't have been too happy with the way they'd finish. He had a big chance to win that second set. We'll come back with a whole lot more. Gee, the Apia International is going to be exciting come January, and Leighton Hewitt is going to make his return.
It's fantastic that I'm going to play in 2012, the Sydney International again. Yeah, it's a tournament that means a lot to me, but to be the ambassador, I went to Tennis Australia and Tennis New South Wales earlier in the year to see what I could do to help try and grow the tournament. And especially from a player's perspective, we want to get as many of the top players to come and play in Sydney. I think, obviously with this kind of backdrop, it's an amazing city as it is, and I think we've got great facilities out at Sydney Olympic Park as well to be able to attract a lot of the better players. And it's obviously a unique tournament as well, big tournament to have the week before a Grand Slam. With men and women as well, and in the past we have some good players, and you want to try and keep drawing those players back. It's a tournament very close to my heart. I've won it four times. I'd love nothing more than in second week of January to hold up the trophy for a fifth time. It's an amazing place to play. It's a fantastic arena out there. When you get 10,000 screaming fans out there wearing the green and gold, there's nothing better. So I'd love everyone in Sydney and Australia to really come and support the tournament, and I think we'll be able to establish a pretty good field.
Sport and entertainment event of the Australian summer makes the perfect Christmas gift and outstanding value for the whole family. The best in the world are coming, so book at Ticketek now.
Welcome back to Melbourne Park, day two of the AO Wildcard Playoff for 2012. Our final match coming up, going to be young Luke Saville from South Australia up against the fifth seed James Duckworth from New South Wales. Both players preparing to come out onto court in just a moment. But the number two seed is through, Marinko Matosevic. It was a good battle, tough battle against Sam Groth. He got through 6-4, 7-6. He'll take on Nicholas Kyrgios. What a performance by that young man from the ACT. He defeated the seventh seed, Matt Rui. Still a very fine day here in Melbourne. 28 degrees. Still plenty sitting in the sunshine. Let's head down courtside with Adrian Franklin. He's got Luke Saville.
Luke, temperature's a little bit warmer than yesterday. Does that suit you, do you feel?
We're all Aussies. We're playing a lot of heat. I'm sure James is used to it as well. I don't think it's going to change too much out of here. I'm just looking forward to the challenge.
Play well.
Thanks a lot.
Luke Saville, who had a battle royale in the final match yesterday. And here is his opponent, James Duckworth.
James, I notice you've got the iPod in there. Is there some particular music you listen to prior to the match?
I listen to a range of things just to get me ready, and hopefully I can play a good match today.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Not wanting to reveal his musical interests, but I'm sure it's got him pumped up, ready to go. In our final match for broadcast here on tennis.com.au. Peter Mercado rejoins me, and Pete, the draw is starting to take shape now.
Yeah, we've almost got the quarterfinals sorted, haven't we, Brett? This is the last of the round two matches to be played, and looking at it, it's an interesting lineup, and there are a few faces in there that you look around and think, okay, well, they're making their mark, this event, and we always see a couple of faces. A couple of names that pop up, so names like Kyrgios, JP Smith this year, Michael Look as well. And it'll be very interesting to see who comes through in this match. James Worth, of course, having the bye. Luke Saville struggled a little bit against Chris O'Connell, eventually getting through. And the junior Wimbledon champion will take a little bit of confidence out of that match, and looking forward to a game against James Duckworth, who made his mark at this event last year.
He did, and the winner of this match will play Ben Mitchell, who had two tough sets getting over Barton. That was out on court five a little bit earlier.
So it's been a good day. I was just wandering around outside, Brett, and it's quite warm. Quite warm out there at the moment. 28 degrees is what we went for. It's pretty sure we're at 28 now, and the weather expected to be even better tomorrow as well. So we'll get the majority of the tournament through, which is great to see. That hasn't been affected by the weather at all to this stage. Yes. We're not mentioning the R word.
And no rest day. We're going all the way through to Sunday. So the men's quarterfinals will be across a couple of days, and semis, of course, on the weekend. The finals here on Sunday from midday. So if you can't get down here during the week, just pile in for the weekend. You're going to see some great action, the Battle of the Codes. You might see some other players on the outside courts just, you know, gearing up their preparations for the summer, practicing.
Now, Brett, we should probably, while we've got the opportunity here, the players are warming up, cover off on some other tennis news from around the place. And the Geelong Lawn Tennis Centre has been named as the venue for the Davis Cup tie first round next year, Australia versus China, which I think is either the first or the second week.
Second week, I believe.
Of Feb. Yeah,
a couple of weeks after the Australian Open.
So the players not having to travel too far. And
well, that's terrific.
Streamers not having to travel too far. 8, 9, 10 of Feb next year.
Well, the Geelong,
2012.
Geelong Lawn Tennis Club has had a terrific reputation over a long time. So,
yes,
great reward. We saw, of course, you know, Glenn Iris this year host the Fed Cup here in Melbourne.
And the move is on now to play at the smaller venues too, just space, etc. A great opportunity. It did go out to a tender process, and clubs were invited to tender for the venue, to be the hosting venue, and there's a whole list of criteria that need to be followed. So your bigger clubs will tend to be a part of that and get themselves involved. And I know from Glenn Iris' point of view that they were pretty happy with the way things went. And so they'll be looking for a similar sort of thing down at Geelong. And it's good for the players too, playing on grass. That's the opportunity to stay in Melbourne or stay in Australia for a couple of weeks too before travelling off the rest of the tour would probably be a good thing for some of the backup players to play at the Burnie International directly after the Australian Open. Is a good opportunity to get some match play in there. Well, we've had a good recent history against the Chinese as well, and playing on a grass surface where they haven't had a lot of success, then it all serves well for Australia to get through that and then try and push their way towards a World Group playoff later in the year.
It does. Great sporting town, Geelong. They love their sport. And no doubt they'll get out in some really good numbers to watch some world-class tennis. Big year for our Davis Cup team to elevate themselves, hopefully, back into the World Group. A tough one to swallow against the Swiss in Sydney back in September. And we'll continue to see, of course, the changing face of our Davis Cup team. Bernard Tomic, of course, being introduced in the last 12 months. Matt Ebden, who's risen into the top 100, has had a chance to sort of be part of the whole squad and the team and get the feel for what it's like to represent Australia. So, yeah, big tie coming up in Geelong, second week of Feb. Just keep an eye on tennis.com.au for all the broadcast details and all the news leading up. So James Duckworth from New South Wales on your screen there. Had the bye in the opening round.
So it's been a good day of tennis already, Brett, with
Ashley Barty again the highlight, but not too far behind was JP Smith. Really impressive against Chris Guccione today and signalling his intentions for the rest of this week through to a quarter final with Michael Look.
Yeah, he's a beauty, JP. Enjoyed his two matches so far. Defeating, of course, Maverick Baines on the opening day. So this one not too far away from getting underway. We'll keep an eye on the outside courts as well. Those scores continuing to come through. Matches in progress. Dane Propoggia, of course, is through. JP Smith, Greg Jones, Michael Look, Ben Mitchell on the men's side in this knockout format. Nicholas Kyrgios, Marinko Matosevic, all through to the second round. We know Casey DeLac was able to get her campaign back on track in the round robin format today. Ashley Barty 2-0 from her two matches, going beautifully, the junior Wimbledon champ. Arina Rodionova has won her match in straight sets against Alison Bai. Bayana Babusic, who we spoke to from WA, that's small upset there, the fifth seed defeating the fourth seed in Sally Pierce. Victoria Rajic against Storm Sanders, 5-2. She leads that match. That is out on court number 8. Isabella Holland still to play this afternoon, taking on Alinka Hubacek. And Olivia Rogowska, Daniela Jeffley. I think Rogowska certainly was up in that match. We might just get a final score. I'm pretty sure she has saluted there, the number 2 seed from Victoria. So we're getting through the matches, thick and fast. Any tweets coming through? Hashtag AO Playoff if you want to send through. And Roscoe, we can give you that final score, 6-3, 7-5. So Olivia
Duckworth won the toss and chose to serve.
Question from Andy Stradwick. Why are the men's and women's draw different in the AO Playoff? More relates to the size of the draws. So it's a bigger draw for the men than it is for the women. So it's not necessarily practical to run a round robin event. Paul Howe Tennis says Matosevic looks like Bagdatis.
Yes, he does.
Adam D. Bain, how many AO qualifying wild cards are there? There's one for men, one for women from this tournament, I think is what you mean. Official Brendo, Olivia Rogowska has had another straight sets win. Go live. So keep them coming through. The hashtag AO Playoff.
Of course, the runners up often have
got it as well.
A wild card into the main draw. So this should be a good battle, this one. That's a way to start.
Nice crispy ace down the middle of the court. Just a reminder, we don't have a full complement of lines people on the court, so the umpire, chair umpire, have to make some of the calls from the chair.
Started aggressively here, Duckworth. Plenty of pace. Great serve down the middle. Bit of kick and bite in that at the end. He's racing through his opening service game. And he goes long, Seville, so an easy hold for James Duckworth. Learning it one game to love.
Oh, Brett, we've got the Australian Open wildcard playoff for the Australian players, but also there's a wildcard playoff for the USTA wildcard that's as part of a reciprocal arrangement there. And the men's field has been named for that to be played in Atlanta from December 16 to 18. Robbie Ginepri, Dennis Kudla, and I think that's Jack Sock.
Jack Sock.
Yeah, he's Daniel Kozlowski, Jesse Levine, or Levine, reigning NCAA singles champion from USC, Steve Johnson, Bobby Reynolds, and Ryan Williams.
Closed out the volley nicely there, with Saville.
Just also on the Friday night, that's December 16 to 18, the World Team Tennis Exhibition will be held with the USTA Director of Player Development, Pat McEnroe, and Jim Courier, he's the Davis Cup captain, to be the coaches. Melanie Udan playing in the women's event, as we've got a conversation here. The women just going through, tidying up on the women's draw. Melanie Udan, as I mentioned there, Jamie Hampton, Alison Risk, or Risk, Coco Vandeweghe, Gail Brodsky, Madison Keys, Grace Min, and the 15-year-old Taylor Townsend are the women selected to play. And a couple of players from the Atlanta area, Arena Falcone and Donald Young will be on hand to help promote the event.
And of course last year, Ryan Harrison, very good up-and-coming young player from the US, won his way through, and Lauren Davis, I think took on Sam Stosur, did she, in the first round here? Good little neckboard advantage. Does Duckworth. It wasn't much of Lauren Davis. She was small in stature, but yeah, Sam got through that comfortably. So double fault for Saville, the first break point opportunity here, James Duckworth.
If I remember correctly, last year with the USTA playoff, we were able to link up via Skype. And have a chat to them over there. It's a good event. And really makes a lot of sense to give, again, some crucial match play in December. No tournaments around.
So second double fault in this game, and it's given James Duckworth a nice early advantage here, leading it 2-love. Early breaker serve.
James Duckworth talked about, had a really good 2011. He's up around his career high ranking, was 260 in November. It's dropped a little bit to 269. But he's won a heap of futures events in Italy, in Poland, runner-up events there as well. Reached plenty of quarterfinals along the way. Competed in some challenger events as well. So he's had a good year as he continues to rise up the rankings. It's
about to turn 20 years of age. In January, the Australian Open's on.
Right,
birthday present would be to have a wild card into the main draw.
He's always been very solid in his frame. Strong physique.
40-50.
This is precision right there.
Not bad shot at all.
Luke Saville.
Saville. So James Duckworth off to a flyer here. Three games to love. Opening set.
Three games to love.
For a spot in the quarterfinals of the AO Wildcard Playoff for 2012. Live here on tennis.com.au. What do you got there, Pete? Around the courts?
Around the courts, Victoria Rajic taking the first set from Storm Sanders, 6-2. Games on serve in the second, 1-1. And Belinda Wilcock is one love over Azra Hadjic there of in that match there, the round robin
and event. Victorian.
So it's all Victorian affair.
Mm.
Well, we've just been handed the Battle of the Codes team list, Brett. Notice tennis is being represented there, of course. But that's okay. So if you're an AFL fan, there's plenty for you here. So Bryce Gibbs and Jordan Russell will be representing Carlton for yes. Collingwood. Shane Wakeland and Tarkin Lockyer.
Shane Wakeland. Retired.
He has, yeah. So is Tarkin.
Yeah, they have.
Still part of the program there, though.
They are.
Mitchell Servi at love three. Saville serving at love three. Got
nice
so many
touch.
Names in front of me. For Essendon, David Zaharakis and Jake Melksham. For Geelong, Harry Taylor and TBC. Oh, it's time for me yet.
He's a good player, TBC.
TBC.
He's a wicked forehand. Saville long again, so...
For Hawthorn, the coach is running around. Al Clarkson, David Hale and the nightclub specialist Josh Gibson. Melbourne, Cale Morton, Lyndon Dunn.
And he sprayed that again.
15-30.
Saville, so Duckworth now. 15-30.
So representing the agents, or the Essentially group, Brendan Fevola and Dyson Heppel.
In the news, Fev, today. Port Adelaide are interested.
Mm.
Well, their sponsor, I think, is interesting. If they want $1 million, they've got to go and get Mr. Favola.
Just completing that list, Richmond's Nathan Foley and Sean Grigg for St Kilda. Paul Hudson and Scott Waters, so the coaching panel getting involved there. For the Western Bulldogs, Wilbur Minson at the top of that list. Liam Jones and Tom Williams.
Shot Saville, so 40-30. An opportunity to get on the board here with a game point at 40-30.
For the Melbourne Storm, Ryan Hinchcliffe, David Kidwell and Craig Bellamy. The Melbourne Rebels, Tim Davidson and Hugh Pyle. For the Melbourne Vixens, Bianca Chatfield and Madison Brown. From Surfing Victoria.
Great shot, Duckworth. Gets it back to Juice.
Deep into the corner of the court. From Semi Victoria, Nick Muscross and Jack Perry. The Melbourne Stars, Georgie Bailey and Dave Hussey will be running around. And for the Bulleen Boomers, Liz Cambage and Rachel Jarry. It's a hell of a lineup.
Oh, it's a good lineup. Tell you what, and the one thing they've all got in common, extremely competitive.
Yes. So looking forward to that. You'll be able to see it here. But if you're in the Melbourne area, it's free to come down and be a part of the Battle of the Codes Saturday afternoon from 1.
Seville, a long service game here. Back to Juice.
We had an opportunity there, just dumping it into the net.
There is a rumour, I'll come back to that, Geelong, the TBC. Half cap. He's putting his head up.
Another double there, disappointing. Didn't you dress as half cat for a period of your life?
I did, yeah. I actually, at the arena in Geelong, did a bit of wrestling with one Benny Graham before he took a trip over to the US.
Hard anyone know you're in the suit?
Hard in those suits to get up, let me tell you.
Long game here, the fourth game of the match. Both players have had opportunities. Oh, full stretch, almost got that. Got racket to it. Got the motor along, been working on his speed around the court. Just missing. Gee, that was close to the line. Just over hitting. A little bit too much, and again, Duckworth with a breakpoint opportunity.
Some sort of shot.
Well, the winner count continues to grow from both of these players, particularly on that forehand wing. Great depth from Saville again. Give himself another game point. Mentioned important game. Particularly for Saville, just to build that momentum, get himself on the board. For a little while now, this by far the longest game of the match.
Oh.
Shanks. Advantage, Saville. So another opportunity here for Saville.
That's okay. It's coming back.
Another game point going begging.
See if Luke can get on the ball this time. He's had to work overtime here. We've been going, PM. 2 minutes?
At least. So he finally breaks through, and that's an important hold for Saville. Otherwise, this set pretty much gone. Get to four love. Let's go to Adrian Franklin, who's wandering around the courts. Got some updates for us.
Out here, guys. So let's start on court number five. It's the Battle of the Victorians. Azra Hadzic is up against Belinda Woolcock at the moment. Belinda Woolcock up 3-1 early on in that match. We've also got a match over on court number eight. Victoria Rajasic is up 6-2, 2-1 against West Australian Storm Sanders. Storm yesterday had a really tough three-set match, so this heat is probably not helping her out. And then on court number seven, where early stages, Isabella Holland up against Alenka Hubacek, and Isabella is up 2-1 at the moment.
Thanks for that, Adrian. Around the courts. Oz Tennis Results is the Twitter handle to catch up on all the results from around the place today.
30 love.
And also the hashtag AO Playoff. We'll also have the results as they come through. Charlotte James looking after all the social media side of things. Doing a great job as always.
Yeah. 40 love.
Girl about Twitter.
So regulation service game here for Duckworth.
Won it after the marathon fourth game.
40-15.
Plenty of pace off that Saville shot, but I suppose if you're 3-1 up, 40-15, you can maybe try a drop shot.
That's long.
Yeah.
4-1 now, opening set. Duckworth running away with it. Here in the second round, the final of the second round matches of the AO Wildcard Playoff.
Any more tweets there, Pat? Any more traffic coming through? Hashtag AO Playoff.
Not a huge amounts coming through. Just a lot of results, obviously, that we've been talking about throughout today. But keep them coming through. Hashtag AO Playoff. There it is on your screen there. Be part of the conversation. Certainly been plenty of highlights today. The highlights packages on the website as well. Hear from the players.
So two games to the ball change, okay? Perfect.
So, again, Mitchell, got his name on my mind, but Mitchell, we're talking about him throughout today. Luke Saville. Again, just wrong-footed there.
15-all.
Saville was up to the challenge at the net. Just pushing it past Duckworth there. So Duckworth was in two minds as to where that ball will go, with Saville in good position early. That's a terrific return.
15-30.
To be. So another breakpoint opportunity for Duckworth, chance to go to 5-1. Really putting his stamp on this opening set. There's the break. 5-1 now.
Duckworth leads 5-1.
Doing it very comfortably, Pete, as we go around the courts. And Victoria Rajic, 6-2 in the first, 3-all in the second with Storm Sanders. Isabella Holland, Alenka Hubacek, 2-all in the opening set. And Belinda Walcock and Azra Hatzic of Victoria, 3-all opening set. Around the grounds of Melbourne Park. Our focus right here on court 6, and a real battle for Luke Saville. And the opening set, the man serving for the opening set is James Duckworth of New South Wales. Certainly made his intentions clear very early, right from his first service game.
Top return. Really was. It came back with interest. Again, trying for that drop shot, which I like the idea of changing it up, but it's just not on at the moment.
Harry will need to change things up at this stage. Nice work there from Saville, moving forward. Just putting the pressure on Duckworth. Forcing him to come up with the passing shot. Nice low approach. And a couple of break points now for the South Australian, the junior Wimbledon champion. Swinging forehand volley, it's into the open court, play very well, it's a tough shot to play. So we're back to juice now. Another breakpoint opportunity for Saville. Another long game. Had a few of them in this first set despite the scoreline. Been on court for a little while now. Oh, that's a tremendous return. Return with interest. Got the break. But Luke Saville will come out and serve to stay in this opening set. Now, Brett, Christmas is coming. Have you done your Christmas shopping yet?
No, I haven't. I haven't put up a Christmas tree.
No?
Well, it's only myself and my lovely wife and the pup, so...
Don't feel the need? Well, if you're looking for gift options, why not...
good option.
Tickets to the Australian Open. They do gift vouchers as well.
Yep.
So give the gift of voucher... But do it with a difference. AustralianOpen.com has all the details and you buy yourself a gift voucher.
Yes, the magnificent Grand Pass is always great value for money. Let's take you inside. What is on offer for Christmas?
Ready, play at Australian Open 2012. A ticket to the biggest sport and entertainment event of the Australian summer makes the perfect Christmas gift and outstanding value for the whole family. The best in the world are coming. So book at Ticketek now.
Ticketek.com.au all starts January 16. The Grand Pass, always great value, particularly, Pete, in that first week, $29. And you can just walk around all the courts. And some of the finest matches are often out in the back blocks here of Melbourne Park. Going the journey. So Luke Saville serving here at 2-5. It's James Duckworth certainly still in control of this opening set. For the moment. Saville comes up with a good serve. Turn there from Duckworth. Yeah. been given some magnificent fantails, PM, but not quite the appropriate time to eat them just at the moment. Although he's managed to slide one through.
30, 40. So set point now for Duckworth.
Just holding his lower back then, Luke Seville. We saw him have a just wincing a little bit yesterday in his match against O'Connell.
So the first set going to James Duckworth, 6-2. Well, as we mentioned, Brett, there's plenty going on in the tennis world. The Davis Cup up in February. We've got a tie against China. Going to be played in Geelong this time around. And Adrian Franklin is outside and he's catching up with no one just yet.
No.
What an anticlimax that was.
Well, clearly you haven't got your glasses on.
SWAT team style. People have jumped in from everywhere. Someone dropped from the roof to tell me.
Taking your glasses off in the afternoon session. It wasn't clear English what was put up on the screen, but never mind. It was a good intro, though. It was going somewhere.
It was. Well, it is in Geelong next Feb.
Stand by. Coming up shortly here on tennis.com.au. James Duckworth. Taking the opening set, doing a very nice job right here on court number 6. And Luke Seville with some work to do, but he faced a challenge yesterday against Chris O'Connell from New South Wales and was able to come through, but a seeded opponent today in Duckworth, who's risen into the top 300.
It goes up a step, doesn't it, today, really, for him. And you talked about those problems he had. He was clutching his lower back. It doesn't appear to be affecting him within the rallies. Hasn't called for the trainer, so...
Yeah, only just sort of held onto that lower back in that last point. So apart from that, hasn't shown any signs of discomfort. The sun's still shining here on Melbourne Park.
Long may it continue.
Tickettech.com.au for your AO tickets. We're only about 5 or 6 weeks away now. Brisbane and Sydney, Hobart, the AO series, and into the big one.
So Duckworth to serve to start off the second set.
Out, 15 love.
Done. Saville just moving forward there. The drop shot was nowhere near for Duckworth. Well, I was talking about the Davis Cup before. Now let me continue what I was going to say. Adrian has the CEO of Tennis Australia, Steve Wood, talking about the Davis Cup in Geelong. Adrian.
Absolutely. As if we don't have anything else exciting to talk about, we've got one more thing. The Davis Cup in Geelong, it's happening. Can you tell us a little bit about it, Steve?
Look, it's fantastic for a regional city to be getting the Davis Cup tie and down the highway here from Melbourne Park. It's going to be a great opportunity for us to showcase the best tennis in the world. We're playing against China and it'll be on grass. So it's a pretty exciting time for all involved.
And what is the process deciding on a Davis Cup venue?
When we figure out who it is we're playing, we ask the players what they'd like to play on in terms of the surface, and the Davis Cup captain, Pat Rafter, and Tony Roach, the coach, look at all of the angles, and then they tell us what they're looking for. And then we go around Australia to the member associations and ask for bids. And in this particular case, we had, I think, over 6 bids. So it was a very hotly contested process, and Geelong put a fantastic bid forward and have been successful.
And the December showdown, obviously it's just getting bigger and better every single year. It's an incredibly exciting time at the moment. We have so many coaches, so many really great athletes out there at the moment. Tell us a little bit about the importance of this event now and also moving forward.
Yeah, look, we're extending the tennis season right from the Australian Open back into the early part of January and now right into December. And you can just look around the grounds here at Melbourne Park. You see, you know, hundreds of people. Everybody who's anybody in tennis is involved here in some way now, and we're going to play over 2,500 matches for the 3 weeks that we're here with the December showdown. So it's live on the internet, as we can see here, and it's a pretty exciting time for us to see the best young talent coming through in Australian tennis.
We've got Luke Saville and James Duckworth playing out behind us at the moment. Do you ever get to go out and check out some of these players? You obviously hear about them, talk about them a lot. Can you actually get out there? Do you have time for that sort of thing sometimes?
I do have some time, but not often, and I do enjoy going out to watch the players. That's what it's all about for us. We want to deliver world champion tennis players and help them with their, reach their full potential, and they help get other people interested in the game, and that's what drives participation. So I do like to get out and have a look, but 40 days out from the Australian Open, it's a pretty heavy time for me, and I don't get to watch too much tennis, but... yeah, it is good to see it on the internet. I've been watching it inside in the office on the internet.
And, all importantly, how are we going?
Very good. I like your broadcast. You're doing well.
Yep.
So it's been fantastic to know that this is going around the world to anybody who wants to watch it. Is a great opportunity for us to showcase what we're doing here at the December Showdown.
It is all about the athletes, this event, but we've also got some exciting initiatives. We've had the Hotshots kids coming through every day. We had cardio tennis today. North Melbourne boys were out there. So they're two big programs moving forward for Tennis Australia.
Absolutely, yeah. Hotshots and cardio tennis are critical for us. They're the programs that we're going to bring to the public and make them drive the participation that we're looking to have. So that's really critical for us, and we've got a lot of other activity here at Melbourne Park right now through the December showdown, and I watched that as well on the internet this morning.
Moving forward, the Australian Open, 40 days away, as you've said, what's your role between now and then? What takes up most of your time?
Generally just coordinating our strategies around what we're doing for the Australian Open, and we're in execution mode now, making sure the site build goes to plan, all of those sorts of things. Then before we know it, the international players will be arriving in the back end of December as they get ready for the summer of tennis. And then from there, we just go straight into operation mode. So it's pretty exciting. We've got a lot of marketing going on that we'll be promoting heavily in the next few weeks, the Australian Open. So pretty much just making sure that we execute a flawless Australian Open is what I'm looking to do.
Well, thank you very much for your time, and I'm sure we'll be speaking to you very soon.
Thanks, Adrian.
Thank you, Adrian. Very nice work having a chat with the CEO of Tennis Australia, Steve Wood. Very busy man and doing a tremendous job, of course, with the redevelopment going on here at Melbourne Park.
I've just got this image now after that interview with Steve that he's sitting in his office. He shuts the door, takes the shoes and socks off, feet up on the desk watching the stream.
Absolutely, as James Duckworth is going very nicely in this match. He's won the opening set against Luke Saville. He's won the opening game.
Hold my calls. I'll be out for a while. Yes. Sits back and watches the action.
And a bit of trouble here. Saville, love 30 on his serve.
Yeah, good hold from Duckworth in that opening game. Opportunity presented itself for Saville there. Just could get across court. Been thereabouts today.
Just be careful of the player's feet, okay? That came very close.
Okay. Duckworth.
struggled a little bit with that ball at shoulder heights today, Luke Saville. Loop balls there, but 2 games to love now.
He certainly is in command. We might just go around the courts and check what is happening. Pete?
Yeah, we've got a win for Victoria Rage. It's 6-2, 6-3 over Storm Sanders today.
Well, it's disappointing for Storm, but
it is.
Of course, Rand Robbins, so we'll be in action tomorrow.
Yes, she will. So, just confirming, 6-2, 6-3 the scoreline there, which means Isabella Holland and Monika Hubacek. That match was moved from court 8. And at the moment, Isabella Holland's leading by a set, 6-2 that set. And Hadzik and Wilcock, 5 games all in the opening set there. They are the final matches, of course, this one happening as well. To complete the schedule of play for today. Points from Steve Wood's interview with Adrian before, talking about 40 days to go to the Open. Well, there's some sort of involvement with the other tournaments, the AO Series. Duckworth, so we're way out of position.
Yeah, huge
tournaments
operation.
In Brisbane, Sydney, Hobart, all form part of that AO Series. Now, Duckworth.
A couple of game points for 3 love.
And really important, you see a lot of players here, they've got a short window of opportunity. Of course, a lot of the European, obviously the American players, winter time over there. They come out of that, they've got 2 weeks to prepare for the first Grand Slam of the year, the first major of the year, and really, they need to use every single opportunity. So, talking about the top 100 men, top 100 women being in the draw, well, you're going to see those top 100 men, top 100 women spread out all over the world, but in particular here in Australia in those lead-up events.
Yeah, absolutely. And you were saying, of course...
Now, Mitchell there... again, I'm saying Mitchell. I don't know why. But Saville...
Can't even watch home
...was way out of position... And he seems to be in a spot of bother because he put that ball into the middle of the court and didn't run for it. Just waited for it, just let the point go. So 3 games to love, and I expect maybe those issues with your back might be causing a few problems. Did have a medical timeout yesterday, so...
Yeah, there's a little bit of strife here, Luke Saville. So James Duckworth in total control, but yeah, we're talking about their build-up to the Australian Open, and now that the Brisbane event has got premier status on the WTA Tour, we're seeing such a great field, and you know, the likes of an Andy Murray coming to Brisbane. We've been up there. It's a terrific event. It really does simulate the conditions that the players will have here at Melbourne Park. Strong field in Sydney here again. The new sponsor, Apia, getting on board.
Yep.
Leighton, the ambassador, Lee Nass, Amstosa, Kvitova. The field continues to grow. And, of course, you've been into Hobart. We'll have that live streaming. I mean, perfect backdrop there. Yeah. Nice little
Oh, it's beautiful. Beautiful setup. I was talking to Eleanor Preston, who's going to be drifting in at some stage during this week. It does some stuff with AO Radio as well, talking about Hobart. And she relates it to Monaco, just with a few more sheds. In terms of the view set up there.
Well, I have been to... Monte Carlo and driven past it. That is spectacular.
It is. The view, it's the cliff picturesque. Top. Looking over the river there. So I look forward to getting down there. And those finals too, if you're not going to be on your computer, it'll be live on Fox Sports. It's important here for Duckworth He knows that Saddle's not quite at full fitness. Purple Pete, by the way, hashtag AO playoff, as texted, had to do school pickup. He won between Groth and Matosevic. Well, Matosevic won in straight sets. 6-4, 7-6. Hashtag AO playoff on Twitter. Be part of the conversation. Work from Saville holding to Love. So on the board in this second set, but
Duckworth leads 3-1.
Holding the advantage 3-1. So talking about the live streaming, about Hobart, but at that same week you'll be here for the qualifying tournament.
Yeah, looking forward to it, Pete. Starting Wednesday, January 11th through to Saturday, January 14th. Although I must say last year we had quite a bit of rain in the build-up, so we went through and played on the Sunday. But hot competition, players from around the world fighting to get into the opening Grand Slam of the year.
Some late nights too, from memory.
Yeah, it was. We had the lights on. I think we were broadcasting from Show Court 3 last year, so I imagine we'll be there again.
And there'll be plenty of websites with that streaming coverage.
Yeah, well, the only Grand Slam to stream the qualifying, so it's a great initiative, and obviously a lot of interest in who gets those final spots in both the men's and the women's field.
Nice work.
Cracking shot.
Yeah, just a step behind Saville there, getting into the net. Yeah, nicely put away too. So an easy hold for Duckworth. Four games to one now in this second set. He's running away with it.
So going to be a really big 6 weeks coming up, all starting, of course, here at the wildcard playoff. Certainly an exciting time of the year. Beautiful weather and the tennis, the biggest international sporting event that certainly hits our shores here in the sporting capital. Asra Hadjic 7-5, Belinda Walcott in the opening set.
So Asra with the first set there.
Isabella Holland going nicely.
Yep, 6-2 and one love now in the second set. So these are the final matches that are being played around the courts today. Been a big day of action. Big day coming up tomorrow, men's quarterfinals. The first couple of quarterfinals to be played. Duckworth in control. The winner of this match to play Ben Mitchell in the next round, the quarterfinals. Some loose shots again by Saville here. It's unfortunately been a big part of his game today. Good attacking work from Saville there, just changing it up. Seeing that short ball opportunity coming in.
Are you heading inside Rod Laver Arena tonight, Pete?
Four.
Big performer in town. Thought you would have been a fan.
You're going to help me here?
Elton John.
Is Elton here?
Rod Laver tonight.
Oh, I didn't know that. The Rocket Man himself. Dolly Parton's been in town.
Dolly.
So break point here for Duckworth to go to a 5-1 lead. Of course, the Foo Fighters have been out at Amy Park, just behind Rod Laver Arena.
Great reviews.
Terrific second serve, ripped down the middle of the court. Full stretch Duckworth there, saving a break point to get it back.
Played it well.
Advantage, Saville.
It's been a tough day for Saville, but you know, he's a good up-and-coming young player. Only just still 17. So Saville is able to hold serve. Still James Duckworth. A set and 4-2 up here for a berth in the quarterfinals.
So hopefully before we finish this afternoon, we'll have an idea of the schedule for tomorrow, but if not, tennis.com.au. Just switch around on the website, you'll be able to find it. Too strong at the moment, James Duckworth. Hasn't really been troubled on serve today, James Duckworth.
40 love.
Oh, that's a terrific serve. A couple of times, these couple of long games, particularly in that first set, but from there, it's been smooth sailing. And there it is again. Duckworth. 5-2 now.
Duckworth leads 5-2.
Taking the first set. And a chance here to set up a meeting with Ben Mitchell in the quarterfinals. So So it's been a good day of action if you're just joining us. JP Smith had a good win over Chris Guccione today, 7-5, 7-6. Ash Barty defeating Stephanie Bengtson of New South Wales, 6-2, 6-4. Marinko Matosevic, 6-4, 7-6 over Sam Groth. Wins also to Dane Propoggia over James Lemke, Ben Mitchell over Matthew Barton, Irina Rodionova over Alison Bai, Casey DeLacqua, straight sets win over Emlyn Starr. Win for the number one seed, Greg Jones, also Michael Look, Joanna Babusik, just to name a few. There in time. Was aiming for down the line, probably could have gone cross court. Saw that Saville was scrambling at the back of the court. Back of the court again. It's been good from Duckworth today's work at the back of the court, heavy ground strokes, working to the corners of the court. Really some interesting quarterfinals coming up in the men, some intriguing battles. JP Smith, Michael Look, we've already discussed. And Kyrgios taking on Marinko Matosevic. Be an interesting game. Greg Jones and Dane Propoggia. And now another breakpoint opportunity and match points for James Duckworth. Deciding to take that overhead on the full.
He strikes back here, so he's not throwing in the towel, Luke Seville. Wouldn't have expected him to.
Oh. Oh, second serve too short and dealt with. So back to juice again.
Halt.
Or tough call. So the umpire that time overruling. Gee, that was close to the line. The umpire only ever overrules 100% sure. Match point again. That's too big. So there we go.
Duckworth, two sets to love.
James six, Duckworth, two, six, the two. Number five seed is through. And in the end, did it quite comfortably. 6-2, 6-2, the final score.
And yeah, great result, Pete.
Very happy with his efforts today. The number five seed is through. Taking on the number three seed in the quarterfinals, Ben Mitchell.
Yeah, very solid off the ground. Served well. In fact, made his intentions very clear from his opening service game. At great pace, very aggressive. And it was a man on the mission, James Duckworth, today. So well done to him. He's developed very nicely over the last couple of years. Inside now the world's top 300 and hopefully continuing to rise. And we're standing by for him to have a chat to Adrian Franklin courtside. We'll update you on some of the other matches and we'll preview what is coming up on a big Thursday here on tennis.com.au.
So while we've got the opportunity, we will check those outside courts. Azra Hadzic, 7-5 over Belinda Woolcock and leading one game to love in the second set. And Isabella Holland, 6-2 over Alenka Hubacek and leading 2-1 in the second.
Let's go courtside now. The winner, James Duckworth, with Adrian Franklin.
James, we're into the quarterfinals, mate. How's that feel?
Yeah, I mean, it was a tough match. I'm good friends with Luke. We train together at AIS. It's always tough playing a mate, but yeah. I'm happy I got through. It's my first match on hard court since February, so it was a bit of a difference to playing on clay. But happy to got through.
Did it take you a little while to get into the match, considering the different surface?
I actually think I started off better than I finished. I came out of the blocks quite well, and then I guess towards the end I got a little bit flat, but work on that.
You mentioned you were in the AIS program up in Canberra. What happens up there exactly? Take us through a year in the life of an athlete in the AIS.
It's a great program. There's 12 athletes there, myself and Luke and Ben Mitchell, and there's a few others. And yeah, basically they provide us with coaching, strength and conditioning, nutrition, physio, massage, and we train there, base ourselves out of there, and then we travel playing tournaments with our coaches, and it's been a really good scholarship I've been lucky to have, and hopefully I can continue next year.
Now, I asked you as you were coming on the court, I was interested in the music you were listening to. You didn't give too much away, fair enough, before the match, but come on, mate, you've just won. Let us know. What have we got? Eminem, bit of Snoop Dogg?
Yeah, I actually was listening to a bit of Eminem.
Oh, really?
Yeah, a song called Cinderella Man. I don't know, my brother told me I should listen to it, and listened to it today, and I guess it worked.
Didn't you play here the other day? Did you check him out at Rod Laver Arena?
No, I actually didn't. I didn't get here till late last week because I was actually over in South America. I didn't get a chance to see him.
No worries. Well, Cinderella Man, Eminem for everyone to go and check out. Mate, good luck in your next round.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
And it was Etihad Stadium too, by the way, Adrian, where Eminem played.
But he was here. He was in town.
He was. All the big names are here.
Absolutely.
So James Duckworth can be really happy with how he played today. 6-2, 6-2. His first match on the hard court since Feb, and he moves through to the quarterfinals. A break. We'll be back to wrap it all up right after this.
Ready, play at Australian Open 2012. A ticket to the biggest sport and entertainment event of the Australian summer makes the perfect Christmas gift and outstanding value for the whole family. The best in the world are coming. So book at Ticketek now.
And here at Melbourne Park, the action has just wrapped up day two of the 2012 Australian Open Wildcard Playoff, and it's been a magnificent day. There's one of the results. The match we've just seen, James Duckworth, 6-2, 6-2 over Luke Saville, who we think is carrying a few injury concerns, but didn't show too much of it throughout the match, but a convincing performance from James.
Now, just his lower back, just quinched a little bit, but he looks to be okay, Luke Saville. But yeah, look, just beaten by a better opponent, James Duckworth, has got a few more runs on the board than Luke. As he said, they do train together at the AIS, but he's been around just that fraction longer, a little bit older, a little bit bigger and stronger, and a super aggressive game from James Duckworth.
Well, that's where we've been today. Court number 6, 7-5, 7-6. JP Smith earlier today over Chris Guccione. A convincing performance, and he is proving to be one of the players to beat.
We like him. 2 days we've seen him, and we haven't really seen much of him for the past 3 or 4 years. Yeah. Tucked away there in the United States, but he's a lefty, very solid serve, very solid off the ground. He constructs his points very nicely. So, yeah, a lot to like about him, and he's into the quarters.
He certainly is. Some of the other results today, Ash Barty equally as impressive today as she was yesterday in her straight sets win.
Yeah, she's pretty low-key, Ash. I mean, there's no real great expectation on her from herself or anyone around her in her camp this week. It's just about getting more matches, playing against quality opponents. She's only 15. Who knows? She could be the real surprise packet and go pretty deep.
Yeah, absolutely. And then the third match today, Marinko Matosevic taking on Sam Groth. We weren't quite sure what to expect. It was a close match anyway. Marinko getting over the line in straight.
Well, there was a bit of emotion out there. Sam, we know, is a walking dialogue. You know exactly how he's feeling after every single point.
Well, he saves us from having to commentate, and that's a beautiful thing.
He fills the gaps nicely. Marinko wasn't happy with a few calls, but that's tennis, that's sport. Some go your way, some don't. He got through and had the bye in the first round, so he'd be pretty happy.
Absolutely. Well, let's look ahead to tomorrow's matches, and it's all the women's action as the round robin matches conclude. Casey Delacroix first up on court, taking on Stephanie Bengtsson, who got better as the match went on today against Ash Barty.
Yeah, and Casey, a good recovery after being beaten by Ash on the opening day. She's got through against Emmeline Starr today, 6-love, 6-1, so that'll give her a lot of confidence, and she's got a start favourite in that match.
The other matches tomorrow, Isabella Holland, first time we'll see her on the main court, taking on Irina Rodionova. Holland on court at the moment. Rodionova having an easy win today.
Yeah, she took on Alison Bai, who of course came in late with the injury, of course. So, yeah, nice win, and this should be a good match, that one.
Yeah, Rachel Trudeau unfortunately having to pull out. And Sally Pierce versus Storm Sanders, and for Sally, needing to get back on the winner's list.
Well, that's right. She's the fourth seed. She was beaten, of course, today by the fifth seed and Bianca Bobusic. Storm Sanders, just keep going through, Storm. I just love saying the name. So good luck to her.
And Olivia Rogowska in our final match for broadcast tomorrow, taking on Belinda Woolcock. So Belinda on court at the moment. And Olivia Rogowska with a straight sets win today. So it should be an interesting match. The men having the day off. Nice of them that they have the quarterfinal stage. They get a day off. And then we'll have the quarterfinals on Friday. So there's plenty to look forward to. Weather-wise, I believe the weather's going to be looking good as well. So it's all in place for what should be a wonderful day.
Yeah, it should be fantastic, Pete. We're looking forward to it. Make sure you join us from 9:45 Australian Eastern Daylight Summertime tomorrow. Of course, our live stream here from Melbourne Park on tennis.com.au. Going to be a great day of women's action. Make sure you join us then.
The opportunity presented itself for Saville there. Just